And we've got the Topp Twins with us in the studio right now.
It's going to be so much fun.
This is very exciting.
Yeah, it is. Because it's a lineup that's never happened before. No. It's history making, a little bit like Carmela. We're actually advisors
to her. Camp leader are advising her.
Yeah. Oh, you are in charge of that, are you? Oh, good. Oh, good. So save your hands.
But the idea of the Kiwi concert party, Tim came up with the idea. And basically, he just suddenly thought of all those beautiful old, the concert party, we're entertaining the troops.
And this time the troops are 5 million New Zealanders who have, had a pretty, some people have had a pretty rough year.
And we go,
let's cheer them up.
And so we thought, we can't just have music, we have to have some comedy. So he's asked Linda and me to be camp mother and camp leader, and everyone will be out on the lawn, they'll all be drinking wine, possibly smoking dope if they rearrange things. Yeah. So I just think we just had to say yes to it. It's a really cool idea.
Seems like a lot of
fun.
They
can smoke dope if they want.
They can smoke dope if they want.
You're not gonna judge it.
It will still be illegal.
Yes, it will. Yeah.
But I think what'll happen is that the police will just turn a blind eye.
That's right. There we go. So, Kavanaugh, I think we're endorsing turning up to this smoking weed, the police will ignore it.
Yeah. And we've invited Kamala. We've invited her over for the concert.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, she's got a little bit of time. They don't start officially till January 20th, that's right. I think.
She's got a little bit of a time up her sleeve.
We were talking yesterday a conspiracy theory that Joe, 8 years is a long time for Joe. If he does two terms, do you reckon they'll roll her in at the end of the first term?
I think that's always been on the
possibility.
Cards.
Because goodbye, Donald. Goodbye, Joe. Hello, Kamala.
Yeah, it's awesome, isn't it?
It's wonderful.
Yeah. I think Joe will actually He'll probably do a year or so or something like that, because he needs to enjoy this moment. Yeah. I mean, his opening speech was pretty awesome.
It was powerful, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was quite powerful. We've invited him too, but we just said, well, let's just go with Kamala.
We've got a limited guest list.
Only so
much weed everyone can smoke.
It's going to be quite exciting because Tim and Bic, they probably don't know this at the moment, but they will be doing some form of comedy on stage as well.
Oh, really? You've got to write them in.
At some point, we're all on stage together.
Oh, that's cool.
And we'll be singing, Tim Finn songs, and, so that the Topp Twins have got to learn some, we know quite a lot of its songs already. Yeah. But it's going to be a nice combination because it's never happened before. That
and we've got the hātea, kapa haka, not the pātea, but the hātea. It's a different concept.
And there's also some other special guests. We've got a full live band on stage.
That's going to be awesome.
It's going to be really fun. And I think, it's just a one-off. You can't miss this one.
It wouldn't have happened if we hadn't had the pandemic.
Artists
are coming together.
You guys are just some of the most iconic New Zealanders, and what I like in my head is that all of New Zealand's most iconic people have their numbers and they can get together for powerful meetings and organise
events like this. Yeah, that's
the drop of a hat.
Well, we're big fans. What's it like being a successful comedy duo? We're asking for two friends.
Let's face it, you boys have gone to the dogs.
Literally, we've gone to the dogs.
Yeah, you're right. We're hosting a dogs right now. Because you guys, and I don't use the word iconic lightly here, you are icons. Yeah. When was the last time you could actually leave your house and no one would recognise you?
Never.
Really?
It never happens because the thing is that
people will hug us in the streets.
Oh, that's awesome.
In New Zealand, we are accessible.
Yeah.
If we were Americans, we'd be, you'd come out of your house from a gated community, be some big locking door slides back.
Three
security people with headphones, and you'd hop into a, darkened limousine.
Yeah.
Well, that's no life, is it?
No.
We just get in our truck, and drive down to the supermarket, and get our own groceries, and there's always somebody in the aisle going, oh, you're one of the Topp Twins, eh? And I think that is so beautiful about New Zealand. We never, ever want to lose that. Because what happens is, if you distance yourself from your audience, then that's what you become. You become distant to them. You don't become accessible.
That's and everything good. Turns to shit. Look at Johnny Depp.
It's all gone,
Then you end up hosting a dog show.
We've got dogs.
We've got dogs.
Yeah. I've got two beautiful Labrador hunting dogs.
Nice.
And I've got a Queensland lab. When I became a dame, I said, I'm going to get myself a Queensland lab. And everybody goes, what's that? And I go, the Queensland lab is the one that the Queen has been breeding for 35 years. The actual Queen in England.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And a guy bought them out from New Zealand and he ended up with too many and he needed to hand one on, so he gave one to Linda.
I've got a Queensland lab. Her name is Dream.
Is that part of the dame, getting a dame and a dog?
We forget that we forget that we're dames.
Yeah, we forget.
You must. You go, I'd be using that to for no. evil. No,
see,
you
but
don't.
That's the difference between you and us.
I'll be getting discounts all over.
Free
upgrades.
You don't really want to pull that one out of the hat, you know, to get something done.
Apparently, there's some little rules about it. Because what happens is
no free stuff.
We did the comedy gala, and on the dressing room it says Dames, Linda, and Jules. So if it's written, if you're writing in it, you're supposed to refer to us as Dames. And in fact, the weirdest one was our bank account. You know how you have your app on your phone now, and you go in and you pay all your bills on the phone. I opened mine up, and it goes Dame Linda Topp on my account. And I go, I've been hacked. Anyway, apparently it's just an automatic thing. If you've got a bank account and you're a dame,
they have to put the title on.
It's such a great honour. You guys deserve it.
Passports and driver's licences.
No, that hasn't happened. No. We haven't renewed them yet, so it may change.
Yeah. Sounds like an admin nightmare. You're like, now I've got to change all my official documents.
Yeah, that's
but
right.
I've got my bank card actually says Dame Linda Topp.
But I don't think Dame automatically gets you a green card.
Oh, right. You can't get over there.
No.
We don't want a green card anyway. Who wants to go to a green card?
No, well, you're here. You're doing the Kiwi party.
Kiwi concert party.
Yeah.
It'll be the
I was actually reading your first gig. Is this true? Well, you were paid $5 each in Christchurch, and you got to eat as many toasted sandwiches as you wanted.
And we wouldn't eat them all at the same time. We'd take them home in our duffel bag, because that's what you wore in those days. Yeah. He had a duffel bag and a duffel coat.
Yeah. You know, and you had those little hoeing buttons.
4 hours too. Endless. 4 hours you played. As
4 hours. Yeah,
first gig. Is that to get as many toasted sandwiches as you could?
Pretty much. And then we'd take them home and put them in the
fridge.
We didn't have a fridge, did we? In those early days, we had a chili bin with rice in it. And then we'd eat them during the week.
Yeah, we'd fry them up in a pan.
Fry them.
So would you put toasted sandwiches in your jacket pockets?
Yeah,
really? Toasted. Yeah. So any pocket where there's a toasted sandwich.
Yeah, they just said
we had duffel bags and duffel coats. You could put really lots of toasted sandwiches.
They just said we could have as many toasted sandwiches as we want. We said, let's just go with it. Because we're not getting paid. We might as well get some food.
Yeah, that's right. It's like the Valentine's buffet. You just never know when to stop, right?
You keep going.
Get your money's worth.
The yodeling. What's the key to yodeling? Like,
the key. You can sing in any key, either A, B, C, or D.
Well, we can't. Well, let's
teach you how to yodel right now.
Okay. Yeah. With the Topp Twins here.
There will be yodeling at the Kiwi concert party.
And
we will get people to yodel with us. The entire audience will be yodeling with us. So
be the biggest
exciting.
Yodel in New Zealand.
It'll be a mass yodel.
The biggest yodel.
You've got to learn how to do it. So I'm going to just teach you. And the people listening in will be able to come to the Kiwi concert party and do it straight off. So the first thing you've got to do is have the break. So that goes from octave to octave. So you've got to go straight to it. It's quite early in the morning, so I might climb into it. What happens is you go...
give that a go. Yeah, no, that's all right. That's a good start.
That's not, really is it?
No, it's terrible. But it's
I feel like I just went through puberty.
Then you've got to do, what you've got to do is you've got to...
put your tongue at the top of your mouth and drop it down.
Your tongue at the top of your mouth and have it drop down to your bottom.
Okay.
Just to the bottom of your mouth. If it goes to your bottom, it's another trick.
That's another trick. Yeah. You don't want to go there.
That's more like the dog show. Anyway. So you add those two together.
That sounded good. It's almost there,
see? You've got to get the yo's and the do's and the d's and the o's in the right place. Okay? Because it's yodel.
So how long did it take you guys to learn this?
7 years.
Seven years listening to wound up gramophones at the Neighbours.
You used to like take a horse, was that right, on the countryside to go listen to music?
And Linda sounded like a dying cat for a number
Mum
sent it to the back of the farm. I never learned to yodel, but I can just yodel with her through osmosis of being a twin. It's bloody brilliant.
So when you put it all together, it sounds like yodel-o-dee-yodel-o-dee-yodel-o-dee-yodel-o-dee-yodel-o-dee-yodel-o-dee. So that's a combination of those things.
Such a special skill.
Is it and a you know what?
We're in our Switzerland, it's just everybody does it.
Everyone's talking. Everyone's just chatting, talking. Someone calls out, you know.
But
it was all sorts of different yodels too, you know. You've got
valley yodels and mountain yodels. I studied it as a child.
Baltic yodels.
Yeah.
So and but Linda's forte is the slow yodel, which is harder to do.
Yeah. it's become a bit of a dying art. A lot of people have died from that, that particularly.
The Villa Maria gig may be the last show.
You might can't get on stage.
It's the last show. It's a new way of saying when you're on stage to corpse, you know. It's not to forget your line, it's to actually yodel and instantly die on stage.
They died what they love doing, yodeling. Lovely to see you both.
Yeah, you guys are so amazing, and we're so lucky to have you in New Zealand and lucky to have events like this. It's so awesome. So go along.
I want to say one thing. It's about, you know, being fun. It's always about our life has always been really positive.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're really so excited about being back on the road again. We haven't performed since March. Just to perform is really fun for us because it's about making people happy.
Yeah. Well, you do a good job of that. Yeah. You do a good job of that. We make people embarrassed.
I don't agree
with that.
There's room for that.
And you are really good at it.
That's true. There's the thing, isn't it? It took Jono 7 years to do that, but he did. Trained hard and he got there.
Lovely to see you guys.
Right. Jono and Ben, New Zealand's Breakfast on the Hits.